Hey y'all, my name's Matt, I play guitar in a band called No, This Is Patrick, and today I want to talk with you about some great music. While I was putting together the last episode about Waker, I thought of another band that I went to school with, although in this case I didn't know them personally. Staying for the Weekend is an indie rock band from Nashville, Tennessee, of course, whose first EP I would have worn out in freshman and sophomore year of college, had it been vinyl or a cassette or maybe even a CD and not a digital version. And now unfortunately, I think this band may have broken up because their last Facebook post is from 2018, but even so, that doesn't mean we can't or shouldn't enjoy the awesome guitar licks and hooks on this song, The Giving Tree. Let's take a listen. Start out with this relatively simple, mostly clean guitar. Then we get this immediately catchy gang vocal.
Sticks and stones may break my bones.
Interesting how on those hits too, the left guitar is the only one with that super heavy plate reverb on it. And now all those parts from the intro have come together to form the first verse.
Going down is my new with a shout of empathy.
And of course got the lead guitar mirroring that backing vocal there.
It takes the blindness to
another new backing vocal melody while we build up this pre-chorus here. And everything opens up. I love that harmony.
The hard times of being young.
And we've got those same parts that made up the first verse, but with an extra backbeat from the drums here. Or a more robust backbeat, I should say.
The engineer's running fast. A blank slate is in my past. The top fades into the sun. When my
vocal delivery and style. There's that extra verb on the left side again.
It takes the blindness to be free of all the sickness I have seen. I am the giving tree.
And those guitars more tightly doubled up and locking in with the bass and drums, and just gives the chorus so much weight. Relatively simple harmony, but the tone of it's just so good. Just as good as this awesome halftime part. Two vocalists trading off here. I've been trying to figure out for a pretty long time now why I love this song and this EP so much, because it is fairly different from most of the stuff that I really like. And my current guess is that, much like many other songs and bands that I love, the whole is greater than the sum of its parts. All of the instrumental and vocal parts in this are very cool and very creative and unique to this band, but they're also arranged and put together and performed in a way that everything is contributing 100%, if that makes any sense. Like, every piece is just as important as any other piece, even just the basic drum parts compared to the lead vocals. I feel like they all contribute an equal amount to what I love about this song. And anyway, I hope this band is still around. I don't really know their status. If anyone else does, let me know down in the comments, or if maybe some other bands have sprung out of the end of this band, definitely let me know about that. And check out the rest of their discography in the description down below. And don't forget to hit that notification bell after you hit that subscribe button and the thumbs up. If you've got some extra time for some catchy rock, check out my band No This Is Patrick as well. Thanks for listening, y'all.